Hey folks, reconnect back here today with another wild fungi for you. And today's video will be a audio and visual learning video for identifying the species Sarcomyxa serotina. And audio listeners, go ahead and listen, and you visual listeners, make sure to check out the description. And here we go. Here is the late fall oyster, or often referred to as being the harbinger at the end of the mushroom season in late fall or winter, depending on your geological location. They tend to fruit in groups, either in clusters or single. Late fall oysters are reminiscent of the more common oyster mushroom, yet their greenish color sets them apart from the common oyster. They are also known as Panellus serotinus. Type is gilled fungi. Distinguishing features, the flesh of the late fall oyster is whitish, tough, and rubbery, and does not change color when sliced. It has a sticky surface when fresh and sometimes orangish to yellowish gills that develop brownish edges. They are easily spotted in the woods. Fruiting bodies range from 2 to 10 centimeters across, are semicircular or kidney shape, often with a scalloped, incurved margin, slightly downy when young, becoming smoother with age. They typically have a stout stem, usually yellowish but sometimes light brown. Their slightly greenish color sets them apart from other fungi, and they have a slight yellowish color where the cap meets the stem, especially when young. Height. Typically late fall oysters are quite short, as their stem is lateral stout and up to about 2 centimeters long and sometimes absent. Habitat. This late fall saprotrophic mushroom is found in forests on deadwood of hardwoods, usually on logs with bark still attached. It can occur on dead coniferous as well, but is more common on hardwood. This mushroom grows in many locations across Canada, the US, Europe, Asia, and New Zealand. Its spore print is white to whitish. Its season, late fall into winter, depending on geological location, usually does not appear until the first frost. Gills. Gills are ornate, crowded, and initially yellowish, becoming browner with age. The gills radiate from the point of attachment. Edibility. In Japanese culture, late fall oysters, or makitake, is considered a very popular edible mushroom, although it is not as common in North America. It dries well and is a great addition in a hearty stew. Its bitter flavor lends itself well to robust sauces. Although considered edible, it is quite tough and must be cooked a long time over low heat. Other names for it is the olive oysterling, and some well-known recipes are wild mushroom protein balls. Sounds pretty yummy and interesting. Okay, folks, that is it for today. I know I spoke a little quick there. I hope you caught it all. If not, it'll be all in the description. So I hope you enjoyed, and I hope you all are doing well. And stay tuned if you like content like this. Hope to catch you very soon.